I'm here at the Durham Emergency Call Center, and today I'm going to work as a 911 Emergency Communications Officer. The City of Durham employee I'm partnering with today is Charles Mills.
My caffeine of choice is either dew or sweet tea. I prefer sweet tea.
I can't wait to see what it's like to take your 911 calls, Durham. Let's get to work.
Hi, I'm Deb.
How you doing? I'm Charles.
Nice to meet you, Charles.
Nice to meet you too, Deb.
So, what will we be doing today?
We'll be taking some calls at Emergency Communications. You ready?
I hope so.
All right, let's do it.
Okay.
One of the perks of being an ECO is you get your own locker.
My very own locker. I feel special already.
Yeah.
Add some Lisa Frank stickers and a little low self-esteem, and I'm right back in middle school.
Okay.
So where are we off to next?
Next, we're going to take a tour to DCC. You ready?
I am. Let's get going.
Let's do it. Right this way.
All right, Charles. So tell me about all of this. What is everyone doing?
Well, here we got the supervisor's console.
Mm-hmm.
Then we got our TV screens. And that over there, that's the call taking area. All those consoles are strictly for call taking purposes. The big TV in the middle, that's a screenshot of active calls within the city. And over here, we have another TV console. And this is just our weather map of the East Coast.
Okay.
And in the back side, that's our fire and EMS dispatch channels. On this side, we have our police channel and our pen channel.
Right, and the televisions on either side of the room.
Yep.
Do you just leave them on the news all day?
Yeah, so after 5 o'clock, that's policy.
And what do you watch after 5 o'clock?
Sports, mostly.
All right. Shall we go on?
Right this way.
So, Charles, what's with all the K-cups?
Well, one of the most important things at DCC is to stay caffeinated. Yeah, I'm a sweet tea guy myself, but you can have at it if you like.
Oh, no. I vote sweet tea. Let's go get some.
All right, let's do it. Here we have our break room. People like to take naps, play on their phone, watch a little TV.
Little TLC, Lifetime movies.
There you go. Anything but the news.
Fair enough.
Over here we got our refrigerator. I'm going to caffeinate.
Yeah, I was promised sweet tea.
I'm a man of my word. Here you go.
Cheers, buddy.
Come on.
Can we go change the world now, save some lives?
Let's do it. Let's take some calls.
Okay. So are we going back to the primary center now?
No, we're going to go to the backup.
Ooh, is that where you're going to train me so I can get a real job here and save lives?
Yeah, we'll start you off slow.
Okay, I can start off slow. So this is the backup emergency call center.
Yeah, you can be as loud as you want here. Nobody will disturb us.
That's good, because I like to turn it up to 11.
Not too loud, though.
Aw. So this is our station for the day.
Yep. This is where we're going to be working.
Okay.
Ready to save the world?
I feel like a hero already.
All right.
Can I go ahead and put on my headset?
Before you do, it's caffeinate.
Yes.
Caffeinated power up!
The elixir of life.
Yeah. Let's get them, Tiger.
Durham 911, where is your emergency?
All right, just repeat that address for me to make sure I have it correct, ma'am. It's an apartment or house?
An apartment.
Okay, tell me exactly what happened.
We're doing our work for a new move-in, and we found an illegal occupant in one of the bedrooms. We've asked him to leave several times, and he wouldn't open the door at first, and now he's just refusing to leave. And he's got the resident here.
Okay. And are you at that location now?
Yes.
And when did this happen?
It's been going on about 10 to 15 minutes now.
All right. Well, I'm getting the rest of this information from you. Someone else will be getting the police en route. Were weapons involved or mentioned?
No.
Okay. How many people are involved?
Three and one person.
Okay.
One illegal occupant.
All right. And where's this person now?
Yeah.
I need to get his or her description. Is he black, white, or Hispanic?
Black.
And about how old is he?
I can't really tell you. I'm just about to say mid-20s.
And what kind of clothes did he have on?
From what I saw, it's a he only peeks out like a t-shirt. I would say he's brown skinned. He has like short twists or dreads in his hair, maybe like 3 or 4 inches long.
All right, and are you or anyone else in danger right now?
No.
All right, avoid this person. An officer, like I said earlier, they're already being dispatched. What's the telephone number that you're calling from?
919.
All right, call us back immediately. If anything changes, you have any further information, or if they leave, what's your name? All right, we'll get an officer on route, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
That sounded a little bit like, you think I won't call 911?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm calling your bluff.
They may have been evicted and, you know.
Wouldn't leave. Yeah.
Yeah.
Has anyone ever butt dialed, but there's actually a crime going on in the background and you have to send someone out?
Yes. Sometimes it's drug deals going down on the phone.
Oh, my God.
You know? It's I'm just telling you. It's everything because it's smartphones but stupid people. So.
Smartphones, stupid people.
Yeah.
It sounds like a lot of people don't understand what 911 is for.
Yeah, nowadays, no. But we get the full gamut. People want us to help them with their cable bill, turn off their cell phone for them, or, you know.
You've had calls of people wanting you to turn off their cell phone.
Yes. Like, they think that you didn't come call 911 to get a cell phone or set up your cell phone plan. So why are you calling 911 to turn off your cell phone? You know, some people just misinform, and if they don't know where to look for the answer, I can always call 911 because they always answer the phone.
Sounds like they're confusing you with 411.
Correct.
Yes.
And some people don't even know what that is. Some people don't even know. I told this lady the other day that she needed to dial 411, and she asked me, what's that? I said, it's information, public information. She's like, oh, okay. Like, I don't understand.
So what is the non-emergency number that people can call?
Oh, it's 919-560-4600.
560-4600. All right, I'm going to commit that to memory.
Yeah, for like noise complaints, dogs barking, things of that nature. And they can also call 560-1200 if they don't know what department that they need exactly.
That's right.
I'm out of tea. You out?
Yeah, I'm out.
It's like we need to recaffeinate.
Yep. You know what? You stay here, keep taking calls. I'll go get more tea.
Sounds like a plan.
I will be right back.
All right, thank you.
No problem. It's so dark in here.
Oh my gosh! What
shit? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Oh shit! I'm sorry. Go back to your naps. I'm sorry. Go back to sleep. I'm sorry. Damn. Hey, here.
Thank you.
Hey, what's with all the angry people sleeping in the break room?
You didn't turn the light on, did you?
Yeah, of course I did.
Oh, man.
What?
Work long hours here, sometimes 12 hours, 14 hours in the shift. So they try to get a nap when they can.
Oh, that would explain why they were so belligerent.
Lucky you made it out.
Alive, yeah. It was insane.
Toast to you. Let's caffeinate.
Let's caffeinate.
Caffeinated power up!
All right. Back to saving the world.
Let's get to work.
Durham Communications, you're on a recorded line.
Yes, sir. This is the number that 911 gave me. I wanted to report an abandoned vehicle in my neighborhood.
Okay, ma'am, what's the address?
It's on Glenstone Drive. It's not really an address that it's parked at. It's just parked on the side of the road as you come down Glenstone Drive.
Okay, do you have a block number on Glenstone or across street?
Yes, actually, it's right before you get to Little Valley Court, which is a cul-de-sac.
All right, and what's the telephone number that you're calling from, ma'am?
919.
And what's your name?
My name.
Okay, and tell me exactly what happened.
Well, the car's just been sitting there for a few weeks. It has no tags on the back of it. It's a dark blue or navy SUV, and I think it's a Chevrolet. Is that the one with the big cross in front of it? I don't know the make of cars, but it's a four-door, dark blue or navy SUV, and it's parked on the side. It has no tags on the back. And I called this in to 911 maybe like 2 days ago. And usually when they come out, they'll like put the yellowish tags on it, mm-hmm. you know, telling them to remove it by a certain time.
Right.
I don't even know if a cop came out there to see it. And it has a bunch of stuff in it.
Okay, are you at that location now?
No, sir. I'm actually in my car driving. I just happened to pass it again as I was leaving the neighborhood.
All right, and is the vehicle...
They should have it on record because I called it in like 2 days ago.
Okay, is the vehicle blocking or slowing the flow of traffic?
Excuse me?
Is the vehicle blocking or slowing the flow of traffic?
No, it's actually up on the side of the street. It's not in the street. Part of it is like in the grass. They just parked it up over the curb or something.
All right, an officer will be dispatched as soon as possible. Call us back immediately if anything changes or you have any further information, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome, ma'am. You have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye. You talked up the non-emergency number, too. You just a jinx today.
Right, I'm sorry.
No, but that's what it's for, calls like that. That's exactly what the non-emergency number is for.
People tend to believe that if they have an accident, they have to keep their car right there. And they don't want to move it, and they're creating like a big traffic jam, and maybe another accident will happen because their car is in the roadway.
They keep their car there like somebody's going to come with a chalk outline of their car.
Right, like the movies. So, you know, but normally we give them instructions to move their vehicle out of traffic, off to the side of the roadway, you know, stuff like that, because in their minds, they think that they have to keep their vehicle right there in the middle of 40 where the accident happened. They don't. Just stay right there while cars are going 80 miles an hour past them. So.
Do you ever receive phone calls like, 911, my wife just went into labor. I don't know what to do.
Yeah, we get, there's a special pin you get for, it's a penguin or a pelican or whatever. Penguin. What is it, a pelican? Which one did the stork?
Stork.
There we go. Yeah. It's the stork. When they deliver a baby over the phone,
mm-hmm.
you get the stork pin.
Do you have a stork pin?
I do not. I have not had the pleasure.
Aw.
But I have been in the delivery room for my own children.
So. Aw. That must feel good to get the stork pin. You can go, hey, guess what I did today?
Yeah. And I think that's kind of nationwide as far as 911 centers. They give that pin. Because I've seen someone who was from New Hampshire come here, and they had the pen from New Hampshire, so it's pretty cool.
Durham 911, where is your emergency?
Hello, Durham 911.
I need to get a police report because a lady backed up and hit me in the parking lot.
Okay, what's the location, ma'am?
It's the bank. I work at the Coke plant on 3214 Hillsboro Road, and it's the bank right beside it, First Citizens Bank.
First Citizens Bank.
Durham, North Carolina.
Okay, do you know the address out there?
I don't. It's the First Citizens Bank beside 3214 Hillsboro Road.
Okay, and is anyone hurt or injured?
No.
Okay, all right, and when did this happen, ma'am?
Just now.
Okay. All right, and how many vehicles are involved?
Two.
Okay, I need to get a description of your vehicles. What kind of car are you driving?
2015 Chevy Equinox.
All right, how about the other vehicle?
It is a Mazda Tribute SUV.
All right. And what's the telephone number that you're calling from, ma'am? All right. Without putting yourself in any danger, have your driver's license, vehicle registration, and insurance paperwork ready for the officer. An officer will be dispatched as soon as possible. Call us back immediately if anything changes or you have any further information.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
Thank you, ma'am.
You
have a good day.
Well, Charles, this has been a heck of a day.
Tell me about it.
Oh, my goodness. I knew this was a crazy serious job. I had no idea the types of things that you deal with on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah, just another day in the life.
Of a 911 emergency call operator.
Yeah. Well, I got a parting gift for you.
Oh, thank you.
No problem.
Aw. More fuel for life, iced tea. Thank you so much. I actually I actually have a present for you as well.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
Oh, I absolutely had to. For those days when you have to fall asleep in the break room, I got you a little sleep mask. Wow. It says princess on it, so people know how important you are to everybody. Or you can slip it on somebody's head when they're sleeping and take a picture of them.
I think I'll go with the latter.
Okay. Well, I better be off. Thank you so much for showing me around today.
No problem.
It's been a pleasure.
Same here. Let me walk you out.
Oh, thank you very much. You're such a gentleman. For more information about the Durham Emergency Call Center and job opportunities, go to durhamnc.gov.